What is today's activity?
Seminar, ma'am.
Okay, now we'll start with the first team, Saurabh.
Hello everybody, so today we are here to give you all a presentation about green chemistry. Before we get started, I'm going to introduce my teammates to you all.
Shweta.
Saurabh.
Samyukta.
Narendra.
And myself, I'm Vinaya. Our Mother Earth has been providing us with all the natural resources we need. There's flora, there's fauna and whatnot. But we as humans, we tend to over-exploit it. We have nothing left for the future generations. The future is at threat and hence, newer technologies are being introduced.
So coming to the chemical revolution, all these years the chemical energy have given a very negative effect and it has a harmful on the environment as well as the human beings. For example, we can take the pesticide DDT. So what does this green chemistry do in our practical life? This green chemistry focuses on the molecular level such that the toxicity can be eliminated even from the beginning. And we can be focused towards this as the world is requiring this toxicity need to be controlled.
Now, there is a question like why do we use green chemistry? Because like a major use of green chemistry is energy, global change, ocean depletion, food supply and toxics in the environment. So like energy in green chemistry is like the vast majority generated in the world today is the non-renewable resources.
Nanoscience and technology, carbon dioxide, waste utilization. And talking about food supply.
So if someone asks you like how would you define green chemistry, I don't think you would have an answer because this thing cannot be defined. This thing has such a broad aim and it is introduced to save the world. Like that's it guys. I hope you enjoyed our session. Thank you very much.
Today's topic is augmented reality.
We all play games, right? Games in the simple pixels and now to the biggest version of PlayStation and all. And our topic is somewhat related to PlayStations and all animation stuff. And more than animations, the experience which we get. So let's start from virtual reality. I hope everyone has used that VR gadget actually. What happens is we get a 3D visual of a particular video and the second of the particular gadget is in the sense that we are physically at that particular moment. That's generally how 3D works. But in the sense of VR, the sound quality and other things which peripheral what? Embedance is the same. Everything will get correlated where we get a perfect and composite experience of the particular event.
Dream high.
VFT is nothing but it exactly stands for variable frequency drive. It is simply called drive. It is adjusting the frequency of the adjusting the RPM of the motor. I show you to guys with the circuit diagram. This is the circuit diagram of the VFT, diode, capacitor and transistor. The three-phase AC current passes through the diode.
Study environment.
The only things on your desk should be your pen and books only.
get rid of everything that might distract you.
Clean your desk of everything but your pen and books.
The internet is a monster which eats up your time, and unless it's used to for online lectures and find subject concepts, only surf the web for a set amount of time.
Distance yourself from all gadgets and other gizmos. The only music which we must learn, we must hear while you study, is your own voice, which you may actually practice well. And it also means we must say goodbye to all other gadgets and especially musical instruments.